What's going on? Craig Clotter here with another Clotter Manufacturing tutorial on how to better the United States of America and the world in manufacturing. That's what I'm trying to do here. You know, why? Let's just serve a purpose. You know what I'm saying? So today we're going to talk about planes and dimensions. And through this video, you should be able to analyze and get every dimension for every model ever known to man, ever. All right, and well, okay, maybe not everyone, but 95% of it, you know, like dowel pin measurements and stuff. There's all kinds of stuff that I'm not going to show you here, okay? But your basic dimensions and analyzing what a radius is and corners and stuff, you will be able to do this at the end of this video, and you will be able to transfer or translate through planes and understand planes much better. All right, so let's get right in here today. Sorry about that. I got to go to this view first. All right, so okay, this current file is from some other malarkey. So let's bring in your workpiece. All right. Now what you want to do is you want to navigate to your planes. All right, you're on your planes, and you see this G right here? That's your G view, okay? That's your main view for every plane. When you hit that, it gives you the top view from your XY machining work coordinate, all right? And these planes are going to all follow into that area, all right? So now, here's your measurement, okay? You're going to go right into this top view. Okay, what you're going to do is you're going to go into drafting, and you're going to select smart dimension, all right? Smart dimension. And then what you're going to do is you're going to just start dimensioning stuff and it's going to work perfect. Anyway, I'm just messing around. So you're going to grab one corner here and another corner here. All right. Let's get this context out of my way. And so there's your measurement. Now, if you want to click, it will my mouse is going wacky here. It'll stay there. You know, but if you hit escape, and I'm just going to hit escape and redo this here. My mouse is having fun with me. So you see it, you can see what it is. So if you hit escape in this, now you can just go to your next dimension. See, that's how that works, okay? But if you want to, okay, let's lock that dimension in. Let's say we're making a print. Now you want to get this dimension. Now let's rotate it sideways a little bit so you're on that circle. Now you see how when I come in here and it's still an X, it's still a plus, my cursor. Then when I move closer, you see the E and then a plus and then it hits the center, all that center. You don't want that to happen at all. You want to come up here and highlight it just like that and then click it. All right, then you hit that center dot and that's going to give you the middle dimension. Corner, whoops, I hit the wrong end. In the corner, it'll give you different dimensions, man. You know, so let's say, okay, I'm gonna bring this sideways. I'm gonna go into my, I'm gonna go into here, okay. And I wanna get a dimension. Okay, it's gonna give it to me, but sometimes it doesn't give it to you. The reason why is because it's all symmetrical within the top plane of my project. So now, if you're having issues also determining, I'm skipping too far ahead here, what the heck this is, like what's this radius right here, you know, and what's this radius right here, and this radius right here, all you got to do is go home, select this dynamic marker, dynamic, you come in here and you grab the surface, and it's going to say right in here, It's a radius right here, 155 diameter, 77.5 thou. Okay, now when you grab this, you can see it moves. See it moving? It's because obviously the radius is moving here. So there's a lot of radiuses on just this one surface alone. All right, so let's click into here. I'm just clicking. So I'm going to come into here, and I clicked right there. What's that inside, sir? 15 thou, 30 thou. But just like that, now you're up and running, man, you know. But anyways, let's say you go this way. Okay, you're in the wireframe. Or sorry, I don't know why I did that. Stay in the smart dimension. And you're okay, and you want to get this dimension here. That's what I was trying to show you earlier. And it doesn't work. It's like, what the heck? It cannot calculate the dimension. That doesn't make any sense. And the reason why is because when you do this, hit right click and then hit your top view. Okay, so everything's from your top view right here in your planes, your top view. So what you're going to do is you're going to click through these. Okay, so go to your top view, right click, top view, right click, go to your front view. Okay, see how your front view is right where you want to be? And now these all lined up on the front view. Just go ahead and switch that work coordinate system and everything onto that front view. And now hit your smart dimension. Now you got that. Now it'll let you go. But now when you come back here, let's say you want to go back to the top and get another dimension from here to here, it's not going to let you. And the reason why is because you're still on this plane in the front. This is all selected. It'll only go on what this is. Your dimensions will only go on whatever plane is selected. So then you're going to go into the top. Okay, this I should have saved this, I guess it's 2020. Okay, and then you're gonna go to the top and you're gonna be able to dimension this shit right up. Okay, now let's say you want to know what it is from here to here. Okay, hit V for vertical. And that's gonna give you your vertical, and then hit H for horizontal. Okay, them are huge. That's huge right there. So, anyways. That, them are some major pluses to Mastercam right there. You can use that on any solid model surfaces, whatever. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you want to see more, go ahead. Give me some questions. I'll give you some answers if I think they're not worth a lot of money. And if you need some help on your own and you want some private lessons, give me a call or give me a shout in the messages, man, and I'll hook you up. Give me some money. And I'll teach you anything you need to know. All right?